Philadelphia Flyers versus the Washington Capitals.
In that first round. Well, there's good news and bad news on the injury front for the Flyers tonight. The good news, Eric Lindros is back and he's ready to go. The bad news is the Flyers lose Paul Coffey as he's out with a shoulder injury.
While it was inactive, certainly did the job for the Flyers. So Michael Renberg continues to pile up the goals and assists. Capitals just not able to find that rebound on the initial save by Ranford. And Michael Renberg does. And he just flicks it past Ranford. We got a tie hockey game. Over Michael Renberg. Goal number 22.
Power play had ended just 3 seconds before the puck wound up in the net. Eichhaus will get an assist. We'll wait for the official call on the other helper.
A lot of sense. Get the puck back to the point. Fired at the net. Look for the deflection. And Eric Lindros, welcome him back with a goal on the power play. And what that'll do is get the Caps thinking a little bit. Hey, continue to take penalties like this, Hickey, because both of it are the result of goals by taking penalties. All right, now stop it right there. Look at Lindros. There's the position. The puck, the stick was out, changed direction, and Ranford, no chance on the play. You know, that's a play that the guys really work a lot during practice. You know, have defensemen shooting at the net, high, low, and just practice deflecting. So Nienema gets it high, the puck drops, Ranford can't pick it up, and all of a sudden the Flyers have a 2-1 lead.
28th of the year for a guy who has missed 28 games, I should say. We're talking about a guy who scores at a good clip, Eric Lindros. He now has points in the last 7 games that he's played, and a lot of them, 6 goals and 10 assists. So the Flyers.
And no face-off, no whistle. The referee said, keep the play going, keep the play going. Watch this. And then on the turnover, Dykhouse fires it, and there's Zubris skating in front of the net and deflects it by Ranford. So the Flyers have 2 deflected goals just by going for the net, getting in front, and they lead the Caps 3-1. But Crosby did an excellent job just keeping the puck deep into the corner. And finally, when it came free, Flyers capitalized.
And Dynan Zubris' last goal came in this very building. That was 21 games ago, and with a big shot, he was able to...
Oh, just blasted it by
I think that was Jim Terry, the goaltender, that night. It's Bill Ranford this time with a deflection. He could not handle off.
There he is, goal number 49 for John LeClaire. That leads all NHL scores. But again, winning the battle on the wall, Michael Renberg to Zubris, and Zubris just shoveled it over to LeClaire. And as Jim had said, with one arm, he puts that puck past Ranford. Ranford had committed early, and he paid for that sin.
That may be the last chance he gets to commit on anything in this game as Ranford is leaving. And Olaf Polzig has hopped over the boards and will replace him. So only the goalie comes in. That's Bill Ranford. Earlier today, Bill Ranford in the skate here at the USA Arena took a shot up high, and he had to go to the bench to recover. He was a tad woozy, and I'm not sure whether that had any impact on his performance here tonight, but he got hit up high right in the forehead, and it was a bit woozy and taken off the ice early, and now he's allowed 4 goals on 10 Flyer shots here in a period and 29 seconds, and it's Olaf Polzig's turn.
Well, we've been around a long time to know that if you don't get goaltending, you got no shot at winning. So now the job of Polzig is to try to keep things close. Irrigation in front of the Capitals bench, but again, the speed of Peter Bondra. Tell you what, he scores a lot of goals because he's able to get around the defenseman on the outside and then went through a shoulder into Joel Otto. So the intensity, the heading, it just continues.
Well, Joel Otto,
so far in tonight's game.
Otto delivered a huge hit on Bondra in the first. He absorbed one there. 35 years old, Joel Otto. They might hurt a little more than they did when he was 25, but he'll be right back out there for his next shift. Scores over the last 3 seasons, and of course, John LeClaire leading all of the goal scorers here this year. In fact, In games which Eric Lindros hasn't played, even John LeClaire is scoring. John, Gary? You're not John. You're Gary, right? But John LeClaire is scoring as he has piled up the goals. In fact, on a 50-goal pace in games in which Eric Lindros isn't playing. So for those people who think that Eric Lindros carries John LeClaire, it's not quite that way. They're both great players.
No, I think the best way to put it is they complement one That's another. Right. You know, when you have both in the lineup at the same time and both playing on a line, I tell you, they can do a lot of wonderful things. And that's what makes our job so much fun, watching the Legion of Doom perform.
Now we know what Hunter's trying to do, get Lindros off the ice.
And it's Zubras in there as well. Peace being restored, but slowly.
Club. Congratulations are in order. Hextall